In this video, you will learn how to find the surface area of triangular prisms by computing the area of the faces that compose the figure. Let's touch on some important ideas before we jump into the lesson. First of all, you've probably learned before that in order to find the area of the triangle, you will need to multiply half times the base times the height. It is important to remember that the base and the height are always perpendicular to one another. A triangular prism is a 3D solid with two triangular bases and three rectangular faces. Today we're going to be finding the surface area of triangular prisms. Surface area is the sum of the areas of the faces of a 3D solid. Let's go ahead and take a look at one example of a triangular prism. This figure is a triangular prism because it has not one, but two bases, which are triangles. The distance between these two triangles is known as the height. That's going to be very important information. All triangular prisms are composed of two triangles and three rectangular faces. We have a purple face, a green face, and a yellow face. To find the surface area of a triangular prism, you will simply add the areas of the faces. Let's go ahead and look at one example of a problem involving the surface area of a triangular prism. Right now you're looking at what you can think of as a plan of attack. In order to find the surface area of a triangular prism, you will need to find the area of your triangular bases, as well as the area of the three rectangles, and you'll add those together. Right now I'm going to substitute in the formulas for the area of a triangle as well as the area of the rectangles. That's my second step. My third step involves substituting in the actual numeric values. You'll notice that I decided my blue triangle has a base of 6 and a height of 4. The base and the height are always perpendicular. Please note that when I'm referring to the base and height here, I'm not talking about the actual polygon, which is the base of the prism, but I'm talking about the base of the triangle. Its height needs to be perpendicular. Don't get confused and use 5 as your height. Your height of your triangle in this example is 4. My purple rectangle, I said, has a length and a width of 5 and 8. Carefully analyze that purple rectangle and see if you can come up with the same dimensions that I used. The yellow rectangle happens to be congruent to your purple rectangle. It also has dimensions of 5 centimeters by 8 centimeters. And the green rectangle, which is on the bottom in this figure, has dimensions of 6 centimeters by 8 centimeters. Once you've completed these three steps, finding the surface area is just a matter of doing some computations. The area of the triangle, it turns out, is 12, and I have two triangles. It turns out that the purple rectangle, as well as the yellow rectangle, has an area of 40 centimeters squared, and the green rectangle is our largest rectangle with an area of 48 centimeters squared. When I add all of these areas together, I can conclude that the total surface area of my triangular prism is 152 square centimeters. I want to go back and review some tips and suggestions regarding the work that we just did. Notice that we started out by laying down a plan of attack. Next, we substituted in formulas for those words. One shortcut that you might like to take, but you don't necessarily need to, is to change 2 times 1/2 base times height into simply base and height. The reason that you can do this is because two triangles form a parallelogram, and the area of a parallelogram is found by multiplying the base times the height. This also works out because 2 and 1/2 cancel one another out. 2 times 1/2 is 1 whole. In the third row, you'll want to ensure that you're very careful to substitute in the right numeric values. One way to ensure that you do this correctly is to make sure that the height of your triangular prism is either the length or the width of each and every rectangle. Notice that the height of the prism was 8 centimeters, and 8 centimeters is one of my dimensions in each rectangle. In this video, you learned how to find the surface area of triangular prisms by computing the area of the faces that compose the figure.